Welcome to the step-by-step tutorial on how to create planning applications in Oracle Planning and Budgeting Cloud. The first time you log in, you can choose from two Oracle Enterprise Performance Management Cloud solutions. In this tutorial, we'll go over planning and budgeting application solutions. You can create the following application types. A light application includes one cube with core components to help you get up and running quickly. If you later decide that you need more complex business logic, you can convert a light application into a standard or enterprise application. A standard application builds applications for any business process. You can select from two options, sample and new. Selecting sample quickly and automatically creates the predefined vision application. Selecting new builds an application with two cubes and the option to add more cubes. You can add up to 7 cubes, 3 block storage cubes, and 4 aggregate storage cubes. Complex business logic, such as business roles and allocations, is supported. Note that you cannot convert a standard application into a light or enterprise application. The enterprise option allows you to build an application that can be used for financials, workforce, capital, and projects business processes. I'll show you how to create a light and standard application. You can create one application at a time. Delete any existing application before creating a new application. I'll start by creating a light application. On the general page, enter the application name. It can contain up to 8 characters. You can't use spaces, special characters, and reserved words such as PBCS, ePBCS, default, log, metadata, or temp. Then, enter an application description. Planning applications use calendar and currency information when you update and analyze data or create reports. What's your planning frequency? Do you plan at a monthly, weekly, or quarterly basis? Optionally, you can use a custom time period based on weeks or days. Select a start and end year for your application. Start years cannot be modified, but you can add years to the calendar after the application is created. Select the first month of your fiscal year. Weekly distribution sets the monthly distribution pattern based on the number of fiscal weeks in a month. This selection determines how data and summary time periods spreads over the base time periods. Rolling forecasts let you manage continuous data regardless of fiscal year end. For example, if you need to review data that extends beyond the calendar or fiscal year and covers a standard number of periods, enable this feature. You can select the number of periods displayed in the rolling forecast. After selecting calendar settings, you must select the application's default currency, as well as the option of using multi-currencies and converting data into other currencies. The standard multi-currency type creates the currency dimension and a hidden dimension called HSP rates to store exchange rates. A reporting cube is an aggregate storage or ASO plan type used for quick reporting and archiving historical data. By default, the cube inherits the application's name. You can change the name of the reporting cube. Now let's review our choices before proceeding with the application creation process. If needed, you can return to the previous pages and modify your selections. I'll initiate the application creation process. The process creates the application shell, adds the required metadata, and creates a database for data storage. When the application creation process is complete, a confirmation message is displayed. The homepage for the application is displayed. You can start adding planning artifacts required by your organization. Now, let's move on to standard applications. A standard application allows you to add up to 20 dimensions total. Oracle recommends a total of 13 dimensions. A standard application supports custom calendars, supports business rules, allows member formulas. Remember the naming restrictions when selecting an application name. The calendar establishes the application's base time periods, first fiscal year and month, and total years. Select the main currency and whether the application supports multiple currencies. As previously mentioned, selecting the standard classic multiple currency option creates two additional dimensions, currency and HSP rates. In a simplified multiple currency application, a single currency dimension is added and exchange rates are stored in the account's dimension. The input cube is your block storage outline plan type. The reporting cube is your ASO plan type. You can change the default names, but make sure to follow naming restrictions. Sandboxes enable planners to keep their work private from other non-administrators as they develop their plans. Planners may want to privately experiment with various outcomes in a sandbox without having others see their numbers until they've completed their analysis. When they're ready to make their numbers public, they publish the data in the sandbox. When published, the new and changed data is saved to the application. You can customize dimensions and other metadata. Dimensions categorize data values. In addition to standard dimensions, you can create user-defined custom dimensions. On this page, you have the option to either manually enter member names, or you can set up account, entity, and custom dimension members by importing from metadata files. Click Add Custom Dimension to add a custom dimension line item. Always review your selections before starting the application creation process. You can return to previous pages if you need to make changes. The process creates the application shell, adds the required metadata, and creates a database for data storage. When the application creation process is complete, a confirmation message is displayed. The homepage for the application is displayed. You can start adding planning artifacts required by your organization. In this tutorial, you saw how to create planning applications in Oracle Planning and Budgeting Cloud. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.